Newport's well known for its wide array of delicious, tried and true restaurants to choose from. But if you're looking to veer off the beaten brick-laid path and try something new, there's help.
Welcome everybody to Rhode Island Red Newport Food Tours.
Fun is the primary goal. Along the way, a little learning, and of course, a full stomach.
Mind you, there are no calories in fun, so you'll probably lose a pound or two by the end of this.
Sarah Emhoff is today's guide. First stop, Mission.
Oh, the dogs are coming out right now.
These are not your average hot dogs. These are ground in-house, topped with a homemade cabbage and tarragon slaw.
I'm not usually a hot dog person, but you can taste that it's like made from scratch.
A homemade taste deemed Instagram worthy with first prize French fries.
I love how they're crispy.
Next up, Nitro Bar.
This is Nitro Lemonade.
They also got a glass of Nitro Cold Brew for a caffeine kick and the Avo Toast, local sourdough topped with smashed avocado, sunflower seeds, and pickled shallots. From here, it's a quick hop over to Hummingbird.
We are on Broadway. This is where a lot of the locals hang out.
This restaurant serves authentic Jamaican cuisine, including a jerk chicken meat pie.
Kind of a savory pastry with a mixture inside. A little bit of heat, because it's Jamaican style.
To cool down, it's off to the Vanderbilt for an icy treat.
And we're gonna actually head up to the roof for a nice view.
Atop the boutique hotel, a bird's eye view of the city, plus strawberry and melon sorbet.
I think you get a combination of some history, culture, and some restaurants. Pleasant way to spend a Friday afternoon in Newport.
After you've eaten all of that food, you can work it off here in a way that you can't do anywhere else in the country.
You may know that the Tennis Hall of Fame is here in Newport. What you may not know, though, is that these famous courts are not just for the pros. This is the only major sports Hall of Fame where the public can actually use the field.
It's one of the best things about the Hall of Fame. I love the notion that we are providing access and opportunity to anybody who wants to come.
Once one of the top-ranked professional tennis players in the country, Todd Martin is now the Hall of Fame's CEO.
It's the most charming and most historic tennis venue in the world.
Now, do I have it right that this here was the first country club in America?
That's the way it was sort of imagined. A fella got kicked out of another private club and he said, well, I'm gonna outdo that. We came down the street and instead of building another 7,000 square foot building, he built a 7-acre masterpiece.
Named the Newport Casino, there was never any actual gambling here. Since then, it's earned a National Historic Landmark designation and eventually opened up to all.
This should be the sports home, Newport's home. We have trumpeted the notion of the inclusiveness of our sport.
In addition to the grass, there are clay and hard courts, a 300-person theater, and a museum.
We just rebuilt the museum 4 years ago, and there is so much that anyone coming here can consume.
Inside, you can track the game from birth to present day, with all the changes in between, from racket design to fashion, even the ball canisters, plus some of the musical talent that has stopped by here for a song or two.
It tells a Newport history, it tells a global tennis history, from a value development in youth to what the cultural impact is of those who've played the sport, from Arthur Ashe to Billie Jean King and countless others.
History is not something Newport runs short on.
The fort that we have today is the second Fort Adams. The original, built in 1799, was replaced by this between 1824 and 57. It took them 33 years to build it. It was active through World War II and is the most complex fort they built at that time.
Its intricate design, however, was never put to the test.
They basically built Fort Adams to be so big and so bad that nobody ever wanted to try to attack it.
Robert McCormick is Director of Visitor Experience for the Fort Adams Trust, the nonprofit organization that restores, maintains, and operates the grounds.
It's nearly $10 million that have been used to restore this fort.
So far, they've been able to cover about a quarter of the fort, opening new sections to visitors over time that are added to the Beyond the Walls tour.
We'll be able to take people inside tunnels that they've never seen before.
Meaning no two tours are alike. And there might be some company.
Regarding ghosts, I usually tell folks that they don't bother us during the day.
During the day, guests are also invited to walk the fortress's 2.5-mile perimeter.
We have the Bay Walk that goes all around the entire peninsula.
Once a symbol of military might, Fort Adams is now a public park inviting outsiders in.
This is such a beautiful park. Any time of year that you come out here, it's truly a remarkable facility that we have out here.
Fort Adams, you may know, is also a hugely popular event space, home to both the Newport Jazz and Folk Festivals, and both festivals will take place this summer. Historic Fort Adams is currently open to the public for guided and self-guided tours, and if you prefer a visit with a more paranormal feel like those ghosts, you're in luck. There are haunted tours in October just in time for Halloween. Coming up, Newport's famous Vanderbilt family, goats.